Hello friends, so in last lecture we have discussed about the implementation of comb filter. We have seen one example that how we can implement a comb filter using Z transform, or I can say comb filter in Z domain. Now today we will discuss one more example. So for that, again we are considering one ECG signal, and it is assumed that the signal is sampled at 1000 Hz and it has a significant amount of periodic artifact with the fundamental frequency of 60 Hz and it has some odd harmonics. So our odd harmonics means it will have at n equal to 3, n equal to 5, n equal to 7, that corresponds to frequencies 180 Hz, 300 Hz and 420 Hz, and we are assuming there is no aliasing error. Now what is our problem? We have to design a filter, that is a comb filter, which will remove the fundamental frequency as well as the frequency that corresponds to odd harmonics of this fundamental frequency. So now what is given to us? We are given with a sampling frequency, that is 1000 Hz, and we have fundamental frequency at 60 Hz. So we know the comb filters, in comb filters the zeros will be located at the location which is given by plus minus n 2 pi f naught in by fs. So now in our case we have frequencies as 60 Hz, 180 Hz, 300 Hz and 420 Hz. 60 Hz is the fundamental frequency and 180 Hz is one odd harmonic, then 300 Hz is another harmonic with n equal to 5 and 420 Hz with n equal to 7. So these corresponds to odd harmonics. Now if I want to calculate the angle, or I can say the location, so it will be calculated using this in degrees it will give, or if you want in radians you can also convert it into radians. So that angle, or we can say location of zeros, will come as plus minus 21.6 degrees, plus minus 64.8 degrees, plus minus 108 degree and plus minus 151.2 degrees. Keep in mind that here Fs, which is 1000 Hz, it corresponds to 360 degree. So accordingly we will calculate these angles. So at these locations, how you will get the zero? You can calculate zero by cos omega naught, or we can say cos omega particular frequency omega n, we can say plus minus j sin omega n. Means we are talking about that corresponding angle or frequency in digital domain. So you will get accordingly the coordinates of zeros as the conjugate pairs. So first you will get at 0.92977 plus minus j, 0.36812, these are the two poles, basically complex conjugate poles, sorry, zeros. And then we have at 0.42578 plus minus j, 0.90483, this is another conjugate zero. Then we have at minus 0.30902 plus minus j, 0.95106. Then another two zeros are at minus 0.87631 plus minus j 0.48175. So these are the location of, or we can say the coordinates of zeros. Now we have to find the transfer function. So you will find the transfer function by keeping all the zeros what we have calculated, and if we combine the complex conjugate pairs you will get the equation like this. And A here is the desired gain, or we can say the scaling factor. And the remaining four terms correspond to eight zeros. Eight zeros means we have four frequencies, and for each frequency you will have two zero. Basically, complex conjugate pair of zeros, and combining that you will get one quadratic equation. So these are two poles, then again these are two zeros, and again these are two zeros. So you will get eight zeros, and for that eight zeros we'll get four quadratic factors. And how you can calculate the value of A? We can calculate the value of A as it is the desired gain or scaling factor. It can be calculated by keeping our HZ equal to 1 at Z equal to 1, that is at DC. So that should be unity. So by keeping HZ equal to 1 and keeping this Z as 1, what will be the value of HZ? That is basically, we can call that it is A. We have to solve that for A. And this also gives us normalized filter. So finally, we will get the equation of HZ as, you can see, 0.6310 minus 0.2149 Z inverse plus 0.1512 Z inverse 2 minus 0.1288 Z raised to power minus 3 plus 0.1227 Z raised to power minus 4, then minus 0.1288 Z raised to power minus 5 plus 0.1512 Z raised to power minus 6 minus 0.2149 Z raised to power minus 7 plus 0.6310 Z raised to power minus 8. So it should be Z raised to power minus 8. And if I found the poles, basically plot of this location of zeros in the Z plane, so we'll have zeros at 60 plus minus 60 hertz. If I talk about hertz, if I talk in hertz, so it is plus minus 60 hertz. Then we have another pair of zeros at plus minus 180 hertz. Then we have another pair of zeros at plus minus 300 hertz, and then plus minus 420 hertz, because we know that this 1000 hertz corresponds to 360 degree. So accordingly we will calculate the angles. And on unit circle, we will keep these location of zeros. So this corresponds to the comb filter for removing the fundamental frequency as well as the odd harmonics of that fundamental frequency. Here you should again see, this should be Z raised to power minus 8. Okay. So this is how we can design the comb filter for removing the periodic artifact, or we can say a fundamental frequency with some of its harmonics. So this was all in this lecture. Thank you so much.